For 13 days, this place, Gezi Park, has been the stronghold of the protest movement. This is where it all began, when the government announced plans to redevelop this place, one of Istanbul's few remaining green spaces, into a shopping center and a military barracks. Environmentalists started to occupy it, and then the whole thing has spiraled almost out of control since then. It has become the worst unrest in Turkey for many decades, and the protest movement has taken on far greater values, far greater meaning. It is now all about Turkey's place in the world. It is about the values that people want in their Turkey: greater freedom, greater democracy, preservation of the secular order. Now, this place has really become a kind of giant street party over the last 13 days. And let me take you on a little tour of it. Let me show you what you can see. You can see stalls, food stalls. You can see political pamphlets handed out at the various stalls. You see other kind of collectivist groups forming. You can see the tents still here as people continue to be camped out. They have not been moved for 13 days. They have been cowed by the authorities. They've been urged to go home, but the protest movement has resisted. If we go down further, we see other groups here handing out more kind of Turkish specialities. You get Turkish pastries. You get a really kind of collectivist feel here. There is a real kind of community atmosphere that has sprung up in Gezi Park. And yesterday, during that extremely violent, kind of aggressive police action, Gezi Park wasn't touched, because this really was the area that the protest movement wanted to retain and that they would have fought absolutely tooth and nail to keep. Now, where does it all go from here? Because after 13 days, it's total stalemate. You had that huge police crackdown on the square, which adjoins Taksim, which adjoins Gezi Park. You had tear gas, which came into the square. There's a first aid stall just a little bit further on, where people were treated for tear gas injuries, for water cannon, for rubber bullets. It has hardened the atmosphere here. The protesters are taking a harder line, if you like, against the government. The Prime Minister has hardened his rhetoric. He's called it all an international conspiracy and aimed at destabilising the Turkish economy. Now, this afternoon, the Prime Minister had, it was thought, planned to meet with various members of the protest movement. But actually, he's in fact going to meet with various members of Turkish high society, an actress, a columnist, self-styled mediators. The protesters say that these mediators do not represent them, that they do not, that they have not had the invitation to actually talk to the Prime Minister. So the longed-for dialogue, the longed-for reconciliation, really still seems a long way off. And you still, in place of dialogue, in place of concessions, you have hardline resolutions, you have division at the heart of Turkish society. And that is why, really, it is very difficult to know where this is going to go and how this is going to develop.